We'll pass it over to Kelly.
Okay. Hi, my name's Kelly Vauden. I'm the Associate Vice President of Research and Graduate Studies, and I also am affiliated with the Environmental Policy Institute as a professor. And Nada Simmons, who you'll meet in a minute, and myself and Lucas and Brady, we're part of the Office of Research and Graduate Studies, and we provide a central location for graduate studies at Grenfell campus, and we liaise with the School of Graduate Studies in St. John's. So there's a lot of different players that you'll get to know over time, and we recognize that. So I think that's a big part of today is just to welcome you first and say how happy we are to have you with us in at Grenfell, even if it's not in person, at least not yet, and to get to know you a little bit, and hopefully you can see each other and us, and help you get to know who you should come to under what circumstances. So if one of the things we do is if you have a question, you can certainly come to myself or Nada, and we'll direct you, or Lucas or Brady, direct you where else to go. The deans and the graduate officers are here as well, and they can answer your questions about specific programs or about the schools that the programs are part of. But it's exciting to see such a big group of students coming in for January for the winter semester. We have different programs. We have three master's programs and one PhD program now, and several others in the works. And so students do start at different times of the year. The PhD program is new. So for those of you who are in that program, we really had a few students start in September, but it's really just getting rolling now in January. So that's exciting. And I know the MFA students are on a different schedule as well. So we have an orientation in September, and this is our January orientation. And as I say, it's very exciting to see so many of you starting in January, and really looking forward to getting to know you more and more about your work. And please do reach out if you have any questions, and I hope to see more of you in the future. I'll leave it at that. Thank you.
Awesome. And so we will, I think, speaking for everyone, I wish we were all sort of together in a room and sharing a coffee and some treats, but fortunately this is the best we can do. But I'll pass it over now. We have Michelle and Todd here, our deans of the School of Science and the Environment and School of Fine Arts. So I'll pass it over to them, and I believe due to other commitments, they're going to introduce themselves and then sort of sign out. So if there are any questions for the deans, then we can follow up with those later.
Hi, everyone. My name is Michelle Percy-Normore, and I'm the Dean of the School of Science and the Environment. And so I'd like to welcome you to Grenfell campus for the PhD program and the Master of Science in Boreal Ecosystems and Agricultural Science. I know there are new students here for both those programs. So welcome to the School of Science and the Environment. This is an unusual year, but we do have exceptional supervisors and teachers, so I'm confident that you'll go through your programs quite smoothly. But if you do have questions, there are lots of people you can reach out to, as Kelly just mentioned, but I'm also available too as the Dean of the School. If you have questions, feel free to reach out to me as well. Grenfell campus is in a very special location on the west coast of Newfoundland. The scenery and the environment is just absolutely stunning. And so if you haven't seen the Western Newfoundland, then certainly take a chance to visit some of these areas, because it is just a beautiful area to travel up and down the West Coast. Anyway, good luck in your programs. I hope you enjoy your time in Newfoundland. And if you do have any questions at all, just reach out to anybody that that Kelly's mentioned, but also myself, I'm available too.
Hi everyone, my name is Todd. I'm the Dean of the School of Fine Arts. I just want to say welcome to all MFA students coming into the program. Our program is relatively new, and I know that I'm extraordinarily biased, but I think it's an excellent program. And welcome aboard. I also say unreservedly that you'll get fantastic support from from Kelly and her team, our local grad office, as well as Alice at St. John. So if you have any questions, please appreciate it. Ingrid Mary Percy is on the line. I can see her photo down in the corner on my screen. Ingrid's our grad officer, helped devise the program. Ingrid can answer all your questions if you have any questions about the program. I just want to say I'm thrilled that you're joining us, and I know, at least fingers crossed, you'll be able to visit us sometime in the future and see the campus for yourselves and work in our studios and be here, which should be absolutely fantastic. I look forward to meeting you when you're around, or you know, virtually in the meantime. So all I can really say is, I know I speak for everybody when I say that grad programs are terribly exciting times in everyone's lives, filled with all kinds of possibilities and exciting adventures, and I wish you all the very, very, very best with all that. Please don't ever feel stuck. Please don't ever feel lost. If you have any questions, reach out to me, Kelly, Ingrid, whoever. We're all here to help you get through this. Wish you nothing but the absolute best. Thanks, everyone.
Awesome. Thank you, Todd and Michelle. And feel free, like I said, to sign out. And anything that anyone has any questions specifically for either of you, we'll certainly pass them along in the future. And we're a bit ahead of schedule, and I just want to give a chance. I know the grad officers are here. And that you met with your students, I believe, last week as a program overview. But I'd like to just give you a quick opportunity to say hello, as there are other students here from other programs. So maybe, Garrett, I'll start with you for a quick introduction.
Sure. My name is Garrett Richards. I'm associated with the Environmental Policy Institute as an assistant professor, but I'm also the graduate officer for the new PhD program in transdisciplinary sustainability. So yeah, it is nice to get a chance to talk to everybody, because that program is meant to integrate and celebrate a number of Grenfell's strengths. So interdisciplinarity and transdisciplinarity around sustainability issues, which does extend from time to time to include the fine arts. So it is a really interesting program. I mean, it's new, it's experimental. So I mean, in some ways, we're still finding our place. But if you're in a master's program and you're interested in a PhD program, I hope you'll consider whether the transdisciplinary sustainability program is a match for you. Thanks, everyone.
Great. And I'll go to Ingrid.
Hey. Hi, everybody. Great to be here. Thanks for organizing this. It's great to see everyone today. So I'm the graduate officer for the Master of Fine Arts in Visual Arts program, and we have today Sydney and Kellyanne here, who are two new students coming in. We have four new grad students coming in the winter semester, and we have five students that are already in the program. So yeah, I'm, like Todd said, you know, doing graduate studies is a very exciting time, and it's exciting for the students, and it's also exciting for us to have the ability to work with all of you. So yeah, I'm just looking forward to a great semester, and welcome everyone. Thanks.
Great. And we'll go to, I think Mumtaz is on the line as well. I can see you, but I can't hear you yet, Mumtaz. There you go.
Okay. Can you hear me now? Okay. All right. Yeah, I had good afternoon, everyone. So I had some good discussion with B's program, B students, actually, last week. And I again welcome all again at this very beautiful campus, and really, I mean, when you guys will be interacting with your supervisor and the courses, you will find really, really a very distinct and nicely placed program in boreal settings. And you will enjoy, and already Michelle discussed about the western side and the beauty of the province. It will really, you will see and find, I will not talk much about that, but if you have any question about the program, just send me an email. And there are so many other people who are here to help them. Neda is always very helpful and very fast in replying the email. So I'm also here. Kelly's here. So many other people. And Lucas, I just forgot his name. So he's also always very helpful as far as the grad students are concerned. But please do let me know if you have any question or problem related with the B's master program.
Great, and that's a good segue then to introduce Neda, who's on the line as well.
Can I just make one comment quickly, Brady? So something I forgot to say is I should encourage you, rather than just asking questions, if you have ideas or suggestions, we're also really open to that. So we're organizing events regularly, trying to figure out what you want to know more about, what kind of activities you might want to see that to help grad students come together. Not only within a program, but also across programs, as it came up about the interest in transdisciplinarity here. We're really interested in connecting students with each other across programs, but also with the surrounding community and with some of our partners in government. And so we are always looking for new things that we can be doing to help enrich our graduate students' programs and lives. So please approach us with suggestions as you get going as well, not only with questions if you have any. I just wanted to add that. Thanks.
Awesome. And Nada, we'll go to you.
Thanks, Brady. As it has been mentioned, my name is Nada Simmons, and I am my job title is Senior Secretary for the Office of Associate Vice President in Research and Graduate Studies. It's a title that we've been struggling with. It's not one that we like to use, but that's what it is on paper. But I am basically your point person for all things related to graduate studies at Grenfell campus. In normal times, I would say that my office door is open from 8:30 to 4:30 each day. But of course, due to the pandemic, I'm currently working from home. But I still can be reached via email throughout the day from 8:30 to 4:30. Any questions that you may have in regards to your journey down the graduate school life, I'm here and I'm certainly available for any discussion. Normally, my door is a revolving door and there's students coming and going every day, whether it's the simple question is you need to change a program or you need to change a course, or if you're having questions about your financial, your funding packages, to my girlfriend broke up with me on Friday and what do I do? So I'm kind of the be all and end all of grad studies. So welcome to Grenfell campus. Welcome to graduate studies. And we certainly look forward to taking the time and getting the chance to meet you all individually and in person. But for now, it's our virtual world and we certainly look forward to welcoming you to Grenfell.
Awesome. And I think, I mean, today really is a whole bunch of information being thrown at you from every direction and all these different people. So the one thing, if you take one thing away from today, it's Nada's email address and what she looks like. And you can always go to her for anything like that. And before we pass it off to Lucas, I just want to introduce myself. I realized I didn't put that down, but my name is Brady and I sort of play many roles here. But I'm also an alumni, so I did the Master of Arts in Environmental Policy program a few years ago. And so my main role, I guess, is supporting the office in many projects and things, funding applications and that sort of thing. I've also supported some grad student funding applications. So I am also, like Nada, available for any questions or things that you may have. And that could be more specific to the MAP program or other grad programs. Or student experience or anything like that. So again, another person that you can reach out to for any support, but we'll pass it over. And I do want everyone to eventually introduce themselves. We'll do a bit of a round table after sort of the more formal part and just to kind of get to know everyone on the call and who's coming in to Grenfell. But before we do that, I'll pass it over to Lucas Neal, who's on the call.
Thanks, Brady. My name is Lucas Neal. I'm currently actually on campus, so I do want to acknowledge that I'm coming to you all from traditional Mi'kmaq territory and acknowledge with respect the diverse histories and cultures of the Beothuk, the Mi'kmaq, the Innu, and the Inuit of the province. And I am a current BE student, so I'm working on my master's in boreal ecosystems and agricultural sciences. As well, I'm working with the Office of Research and Grad Studies in a student support role. So trying to just sort of support students the best that we can. I'm going to share my screen here now and go through a quick little presentation on some of the ways that we can support students. if I can figure out how to do this. Can you see this presentation?
Yep.
Beautiful. So there's a beautiful picture of Grenfell campus. It's a really beautiful campus. You can see how lovely it's surrounded by all the nice foliage, and Mumtaz mentioned that earlier too, and as well as Michelle, all the beautiful scenery that we're within. So hopefully those of you that aren't on campus or in sort of Western Newfoundland here will be able to come see it at some point. So I'm just going to sort of do a quick overview, a little bit of an explanation of sort of how grad studies is separated here. And Kelly mentioned that earlier. And then I'll talk about our orientation webpage. In the fall of 2020, we set up orientation all online through a webpage, just because, you know, we couldn't have people in person. Normally we would do a big in-person thing, but we figured we would try to put everything on one webpage. And so we're lucky we can still use that webpage and update it a little bit for this winter semester. I'll introduce you to the Grad Student Union. So as a grad student, we pay fees to the union. And so I'll tell you sort of what that does, what they do for you. And then I'll introduce you as well to the Grenfell Grad Student Society, on-campus society for graduate students.
So, and Jackie, sorry, Lucas, Jackie will be on the call, so we can give her a chance to introduce herself as well.
Okay, perfect. Awesome. And so graduate studies itself, the School of Graduate Studies is based on St. John's campus. And so as was mentioned earlier, though, we have the Office of Research and Grad Studies here on our campus, which consists of Nada, Kelly, Brady, and myself. And so, again, your best sort of contact there is Nada Simmons. So if you have anything sort of graduate studies related and you're not sure where to go, definitely go to Nada. And then if she thinks, you know, you have to go to someone in St. John, she's great at redirecting that. And so a little bit about sort of the Grad Student Union. As I said, we pay a fee to them once a semester, and they are based on St. John's campus. They do have a coordinator for our campus, which is currently me. And so that person just sort of provides the services that the student union provides in St. John's. They help connect those services to our campus. And the email is there as well. I'll put my personal email in the chat, which is easier to reach me. We also have the Grenfell Graduate Student Society, which we're going to get to in a little bit. And the point of contact there is Jackie, and I'll let her introduce herself later once I get to that slide. Because I see her beautiful face on this call now. Now I'm going to just give you a brief overview of the orientation webpage, which I think I need to stop sharing for a sec and do this and this. I guess I could just do this. Can you see the orientation webpage? Yeah, beautiful. So this is our orientation webpage, and we'll send out the link to students as well, and we can post it in the chat there. It has a few resources here. The main four are right here on this page, with the first one being a welcome to Cornerbrook. And so that's with hopes that one day you'll be able to come to Cornerbrook. You can get familiar with the area before you arrive. So it just has some of the different services and stuff that you might be interested in looking at before you do arrive in Cornerbrook. We also have a lot of resources listed for grad students. So I won't go through all of them, but they are listed beautifully here, and they're broken up into different sections. So the Grenfell services are all the services that we offer on Grenfell campus. Learning online sort of has how to best optimize your online learning and use different platforms. And then COVID-19 resources, this sort of allows you to better understand sort of MUN's COVID policies and what's going on with related to COVID-19. here at Memorial University. And as well, we have In this section, we also have some recordings from our orientation sessions in the fall. So those might be interesting to check out. We have one about funding your graduate degree, as well as we have some of the overviews from the programs. We have we did an intercultural diversity. So those are just there for you to go through at your leisure. Have a connect with Grenfell just to give you a little sense of who you might be working with, who you might run into in the virtual hallway. Since we're not, you know, running into each other in the hallways these days, at least if you're emailing someone, you might get a little bit of a sense of who they are. And then as well, we have the grad studies 501 a Bright Space Shell. So Grad Studies in St. John's has put together an orientation Bright Space Shell, and so we have the link to that there. So that's our orientation website. It's a good resource when you're coming into a program here and just sort of trying to figure things out. It might answer a lot of questions. I'll jump back to the PowerPoint here. So a little bit about the Grad Student Union. They're here sort of as student representation and to advocate for you. They do run some student campaigns. They have some financial supports, as well as financial coverage, and then some events. So they represent and advocate for you on all levels, within all levels of the university. Whether it's an academic issue or any other issues that you might have within the university, they are here for you. They do run some student campaigns, whether it's about funding the future, fighting tuition fees, racism, climate change, stuff like that. There are lots of different ways to get involved. So if that's something you're interested in, the Grad Student Union runs lots of different campaigns. A little bit about the financial support. So you do pay student fees to the student union. So it's always nice to know what are they going to do for you. So they do provide conference funding. You might not be going in person to a conference these days, hopefully one day soon. But if you're attending a virtual conference, this funding is still available. And you can get up to $250 for master's students and up to $500 for doctoral students. They have a professional membership grant. So if you're applying to be part of a professional association, you can get reimbursed up to $50 per year for that application process. So if there's a membership that you're like, oh, I really wanted to be part of this association, but it's a bit of money, they can help provide assistance with that. As well, if you're part of a seminar or a workshop, so it may not be a conference specifically, but maybe it's a workshop that's sort of going to supplement what you're learning, they can provide funding as well for that. Then they have funding for societies. So if you're thinking of maybe you want to start an on-campus society, there's funding for that. As well, this sort of briefly covers their health and dental coverage. So as part of your student fees, we do pay health and dental coverage, which if you already have coverage through a different workplace or something else, you can opt out of. And so this just sort of goes through the coverage a little bit, and you'll be getting an email shortly from me on how to sort of sign up for that coverage and log in and get all of that sorted out. That'll come in the next few days, hopefully. And then they do have events, and one of the big events they have is called the Aldridge Conference. And so this is a great way for students who maybe haven't attended a lot of conferences to get that conference experience and sort of boost your morale about going to conferences, sort of take the scariness away from them. And so this is an interdisciplinary conference, and it's for grad students of Memorial University. So it's with your colleagues, and it's with students as well in St. John's. And they have different workshops and panels, social opportunities. In person, when it's in St. John's, it's a great opportunity to present your research and you know, learn how to make a poster or presentation for a conference. It's a really good starting point for that. And then within sort of since the Grad Student Union is on St. John's campus, On our campus here in Corner Brook, we have the Grenfell Graduate Student Society, which is a society under the Grad Student Union. And our representative for that is Jackie, and I see she's here, so we'll order her.
Hello, thank you for introducing me, Lucas. So I'm Jackie, and I am in the Master's Program of Environmental Policy. So I'm in my second year now. And I'm currently the president of the Grenfell Graduate Student Society. It's been very different for us this year, as it's all virtual. But typically, we would be running different events. So we've been trying to come up with new creative ideas for how we can continue to keep grad students that are a part of Grenfell to stay connected. That's pretty much our main purpose, is to connect grad students with each other and to help grads from different programs to connect with one another. We've got the BEES program and the MAP program and the MFA and the new PhD program. And so we really just want to create spaces and times for grads to connect with one another. And one way, which is new for this year, is we have a Discord channel. And so I'm going to post a link in the chat. And there's an invite for you to click on, and then you can see the grad channel. We want to get it more active this year, and we're getting some other things up and going with the grad student network. We've got a Microsoft Teams page as well, which is another way for grad students to get connected. I can also post a link for that in the chat here. And so these are just two great opportunities for you to chat with other grads, and with the Teams page, you can also connect with professors as well. It's just an open space. And so if any of you do have questions that maybe relate to student life or grad studies, the idea is that you can come to the GGSS and we can connect you with someone else who can help you. We can connect you with different faculty, but we're just here for your support, and we want to be able to help make the most out of your grad experience. And we're always looking for more feedback too, so that's another thing that you can come to us with ideas. We're very open to that. So yeah, that's pretty much to sum things up for the GGSS.
Awesome. Thank you, Lucas and Jackie, for being here. And at this point, I just want to, we're about 12:30, so we have about 30 minutes. I just want to give everyone a chance who hasn't yet introduced themselves to do so, and for all the students. And my questions to you basically are just your name, where you're from, and where you are currently, so that may be different. What program you're in, obviously, and the cheesy one interesting thing about yourself that no one else may know. So first on my screen is Kamal. And I apologize if I mispronounced your name. If I do, just let me know how to actually say it when you start talking.
Thank you very much for giving me the floor. And I'm very excited to join in first ever Board Orientation Program. So please, can you hear me? Oh, yeah. Just I'm very excited to join in the presentation program, and really you are very helpful, and because you discuss everything elaborately, and I think that I could be well organized with your program. And my program name is doctoral program, the TSIU, Transdisciplinary Sustainability. And I am working as a professional engineer in Bangladesh. I work with the irrigation. I have 7 years of experience in the irrigation field and water management field. So I decided to work in the more deep knowledge about the climate change with the changing water resource management. That is, this is the main topics. And that I want to work with the climate change in the changing water resource management. And in that prospect, I want to compare it is in the Newfoundland and in Bangladesh. So I think that you are really very helpful, and I have an experience. I did my master's in Sweden, Swedish University, and there is heavy cold there. And I see that in Canada and Sweden is similar environment. So I think that I could work well there. So there is no problem, I think. And Canada is also very, now maybe minus or 0 degrees Celsius there in Newfoundland. So I have really different, that is, I can well with the environment. And I think that in this program, this is not, this is the new program, Transdisciplinary Sustainability, but I think it is very well organized. And your teaching environment, and I think that it's everybody, Dr. Richard Garrett and Nadia Simons, I already known them with the email, because if I send any queries them, they immediately reply me. And I really thanks to you all. And I also thanks to all other who are presenting well. And really, it's a nice, amazing. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you for being here. And I'm not sure what time it is over there, but I'm sure it's not noon like it is here. So next we'll go to Kellyanne.
It's weird I'm in my own house, but I feel like I'm talking to a group. It makes me nervous, you know. I'm in the MFA program. I'm from South Florida. And I also think Canada has heavy cold, Kamal. I think Canada is heavy cold. I'm interested in white trash culture and kind of casting a critical eye on the way white supremacy damages all of us through an anti-racist lens. And something interesting, I ride my bike across the country. I've lived on my bike for like 6 months at a time. I've lived in the woods. I've skinned a bear. I'm excited to learn. Let's learn.
Wow. awesome. Cool. So let's go to Leanna next.
Hi, everyone. I'm Leanna. I'm in the Transdisciplinary Sustainability Program. I'm based in Corner Brook, so I live in Corner Brook right now. And my thesis research, I'm being co-supervised by Cameron Forbes in the Visual Arts Department and Kelly Vauden, who's on the call. I'll be looking at how fences visualize or represent socio-spatial differences in mining communities. So I'm excited to kind of do that. Something interesting about me, people are usually surprised to find out that I hate oranges, but grapefruits are my favorite fruit. So it's a bit weird. And that's awesome.
And just to mention also that Leanna is also an alumni of the MAP program and works a bit with the office with Kelly as well. So you may see us and her doing some events and other things throughout the year as well. Next, we'll go to Lucas Garcia.
Hello, everyone. Can you hear me? Yeah. Hello. My name is Lucas. I'm from Brazil. I'm still here, still struggling to get my visa to finally go to Canada. I'll be joining the PhD program on transdisciplinary sustainability as well. I'm very excited to join the Grenfell community and start my PhD program. I'll be working with bioeconomy, more specifically the forest-based bioeconomy, and all the opportunities and challenges related with it. I'm supervised by Dr. Stephen Decker as well, co-supervised by Dr. Kelly Vauden and also John Dagavos. And yeah, a curiosity maybe is that people are always telling about that January, it's not the best time to go to Canada. But I've been to Canada once in 2013, and I lived there for a year. And I've also arrived right in the middle of January. And people were always telling the same thing. And now I'm saying, okay, I've been there. in January 1. So I, at least I had the memory of that. And yeah, hopefully, probably not in, in January, the visa is going to be ready, but as soon as possible to join Canada. Yeah.
Great. I'd be more than happy to switch places in South America and experience summer right now. we'll go next, and I apologize, I may mispronounce the name, but Onyinye.
Hello, everyone. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, my name is Onyinye Gift Anyang. I'm from Nigeria. I'm still currently in Nigeria, trying to get my study permit to come to Canada. I'll be working with Dr. Lord Abe, working on growing media formulation to check its effect on plant growth and various physiological characters. I am currently working in Nigeria as an assistant lecturer where I do a lot of physiological work. I think one interesting, I don't know if it's interesting or boring fact about me, is the fact that I just like to do a lot of research and I don't have a social life that much. So I'm hoping I don't come to Canada and bury myself in research. I've heard that it's very easy to do that there.
Well, I mean, it certainly would not go astray at the Office of Research, that's for sure. Thank you so much. And thank you again, everyone who's joining us from everywhere around the world. It's awesome to, unfortunate that we can't be together, but very cool that you're able to join us from where you are. And as well, in the future, let us know if this, we tend to have meetings for around this 12:30, 1 p.m. Newfoundland time. If it's like 2 a.m. where you are and it's not really working out, let us know. And we'll try and make a time that works for everyone. I'll go to Sydney Lancaster now.
Hi, everybody. I'm Sydney Lancaster. I'm a visual artist. I'm starting the MFA program with Kellyanne. Oh my goodness. Yeah, this is going to be fun. This is going to be incredibly fun. I'm so excited. Stuff I'm interested in, I just dropped a chat to Liana. I'm interested in settler culture. I'm interested in boundary theory. I'm interested in the way we navigate memory and identity and place, and how those things come together, and the idea of the relationship between identity and settler notions of ownership of land. There's lots of interesting stuff to look at there. I am a prairie girl. I'm not in Alberta right now, but I'm currently based in Edmonton, Alberta. So almost all the way across the country for the MFA, and super excited to be in a part of the country that I love. I adore the west coast of Newfoundland. I adore Newfoundland. It's lovely. Right now, I'm in Wolfville, Nova Scotia, which is also a brilliant part of the country. I'm trying to think of weird things that people don't know about me. I don't know. I can't think of anything, darn it. I don't hate oranges. I'm not a big fan of grapefruits, so I guess that's kind of the play there. Avocado love, I don't know. I think avocados are awesome.
Awesome.
Anyway, really looking forward to being on campus hopefully soon, and getting into the program. I also want to shout out to everybody at Grenfell, Nada. Den mother? Is that a good official den mother? Nada has been incredible. The fine arts department, Todd and Ingrid and everybody there have been so wonderful and so welcoming and so helpful. And everybody here, everybody at Grenfell in this crazy, weird time, has been nothing but helpful and responsive so far, and very accessible and very human. So props to you all. It's really tough, and you have been anything but institutional and bureaucratic. So full points.
Awesome.
That's all I got.
Thanks. And I can assure you that I believe most of us are human. Sometimes I think Nada is superhuman, depending on how many emails she gets a day. But so we'll go to who's next on my Kara Brewer.
Okay, can you hear me?
Yep.
Awesome. So my name is Kara. I'm from Austin, Texas, and I'm currently in Corner Brook. Yay, on my self-isolation period, so stuck inside. I'll be in the BEES program. My supervisor is Dr. Aaron Frazier, and my project is studying the movement and migration of little brown bats using strontium and stable isotopes. I am not much of a bat person, but I'm excited to learn more about them. And as you can imagine, I've been getting a lot of questions about COVID and its relation to bats, which, to be honest, I have no idea about. I'm not an epidemiologist, so if you ask me about that, I will tell you to ask someone else. Something interesting about me is my husband and I are big rock climbers, so we spent a long time living out of our van climbing all over the US, which was really awesome.
Cool. And I know there are some great climbing spots around Corner Brook as well, so we can put you in touch with some. I definitely do not climb. That would be very dangerous if I did climb, but I know people who do, so we can put you in touch with those as well once you're out of quarantine. And I hope quarantine isn't too bad.
Not too bad.
We do have undergrad students that climb, so that could be a good connection there.
And we'll go to who's next on my list? Elham? Not sure if I'm saying that right.
Hello, everyone. Can you hear me?
Yep.
My name is Elham. I'm from Iran. Engineering and
sorry for interruption. Elham is our student from Iran.
Yeah. Hello, Dr. Chima. I'm supervised by Professor Galagadara and Professor Chima. I'm waiting for my study permit. And I'm so excited to join the Grenfell campus in the Boreal Ecosystems and Agricultural Sciences.
Awesome. And I will say as well, if those on the call are more comfortable or would like to just sort of introduce themselves in the chat, feel free to do so if that's easier for you as well. Otherwise, I'll move on to Harbe, is the name on the screen. Not sure if they're there or able to unmute. Okay, I will, if you are there and you're just trying to unmute, feel free to let me know in the chat and we'll come back.
Okay. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Okay, good day everyone. My name is Abiel. I'm calling from Nigeria. I actually just closed from work, so I'm in transit. So sorry if you're unable to get me very well. So I'm a graduate student studying BS. That's to be supervised by Dr. Lash. So it's nice joining everyone. I may have to run. Can you hear me actually?
Yep. Loud and
clear.
Can
you hear me?
Yep.
Okay. So I'm going to be supervised by Dr. Lashman. I'm waiting for my study permit to be approved as well. So I really look forward to coming down as soon as that happens. So thanks for the time, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you for joining in on your commute home.
Okay, thank you.
And next we'll go to Indiwari Bandara.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yep.
Yes, I'm Indiwari Bandara from Sri Lanka. And I'm following MSCC in Boreal Ecosystems and Agricultural Sciences. And I'm supervised by Dr. Galakidro. And I'm really excited to see you all here. And I hope, it was nice to see you all.
Great. Thanks so much for being here. And we have a couple left. We'll go to Megan Doyle.
Hi. I would use my video, but it's doing this really weird thing right now. I don't know if it looks weird on your end.
Yeah, it's a little like a slideshow.
So I'm coming from New Brunswick. I'm currently quarantining on Grenfell campus. I'm going to be in the BEES program with Julie Sircom as one of my supervisors, and I'll be working with the Canadian Forest Service on spruce budworm research. And I've been working in forestry for 8 years, so that's definitely right up my alley. And something interesting about me, I guess I've traveled to all provinces and territories except for Nunavut, and I've been to all the US states except for 16 that I have left.
Wow. Very, very cool. So next we'll go to Salman. Salman?
Salman.
Salman.
Hello.
Hello. Yep, we can hear you.
Can you hear me?
Yep.
My name is Salman and I am from Pakistan. I am in MSc honor Boreal Ecosystem and Agriculture Sciences. And my supervisor is Dr. Mumtaz Chima and Dr. Lakshman Galureta.
Awesome. Thank you. Thank you again for being here. And we'll go to our last on the call, Sabuni. Sabuni?
Yes. Hi. This is me, Sabuni.
Yep.
And I'm from Sri Lanka. I'm studying Masters of Boreal Ecosystem and Agriculture Science under Professor Dr. Thomas Raymond. And I'm here happily in Wheeler's Road, so we are having a little bit small problem with the internet connection. That's why my video is like off for the moment. And we had good times in and for the last few days with our isolation and everything. Snow was nice on yesterday. Everything's quite perfect. So yeah, hope to see you guys. Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone. And hope to see you guys very soon. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Awesome. It's great to see so many people that are in Corner Brook and those that are waiting to come. And we're really excited for you all to be here. Obviously, I think we wish you the best on your travels and to stay safe and those things as well. But it'll be great to have those everyone here on campus. And for those that are in Corner Brook, and you'll get an email from Lucas on this afterward, but he is right now in one of the grad spaces that we have available on campus. So we have about 23 spaces available on campus where grad students are actually able to work from campus if you'd like. So that could be whether you may have a bad internet connection at home or just like a space to work. Essentially what will happen is you can send us your information and the days you'd like to be on campus, what days work best for you, and we'll set you up in a room, and that will sort of be, if you're based in one room, that'll be your space. So you'll have a little desk area that you can have your own so that we're not sort of overlapping spaces and using the same space, just to make sure that, regulation-wise, we're compliant we can have a conversation about that at a future time for those that do want to be on campus, but just letting you know that is certainly a possibility. And anything else, I'm gonna open up the floor for a quick discussion. We have about 10 minutes before 1 o'clock here in Newfoundland. But is there anything else that we've missed or things you'd like to bring up, anything from Nada or Kelly or Lucas or the grad officers or.
One thing I was thinking about, for those that are in quarantine, Megan and Kara, I hope everything is going okay. I know that the university is checking in with people regularly, and but if there's anything that you need, I know it must be difficult. And for those of you who are going to be quarantining for 2 weeks when you arrive, we do have systems in place. I hope it's going well as you can be, but please do let us know if you need help when you arrive.
Absolutely. Yeah, our services extend beyond. So great. Go ahead, Nita.
Sorry about that, Brady. I'd just like to add to what Kelly said as well. We know that, you know, there is a team established at Grenfell for checking in with people who are in isolation. And that, but if for some reason something happens and you can't get hold of anybody or whatever, certainly feel free to reach out to us. And also for those who come out of isolation and are probably moving into the community, not necessarily living in residence, but are moving into the community and establishing your apartment or your home, whatever the case is. If you're in need of things and items or you don't know the right person to connect to find those things that you may need, whether it's a set of pots and pans or whatever your need may be, certainly reach out to us. Don't hesitate to contact me. Send me an email. And I always say to students, if I don't know the answer, I'll find someone who can provide that information for me. So by all means, certainly reach out to us no matter what the issue is, and we're here to help.
If I could just jump in for a second as well. I've already mentioned this to our grad students that are coming in, but basically I'm gonna be working with Kelly and Nada and everybody to coordinate the four graduate students who are coming in this spring. Just to let this, you know, Kellyanne and Sydney know that we'll be coordinating that sort of. I'll be working with grad studies, and then I'll be sort of relaying that information to you. So it's not up to you individually at this point to have to do that.
And I will say, it's a small campus here with a few people working on different things. So it's great to. You know, we all know each other and we all work together on different things. So it's never, you know, you ask one person and they don't talk to someone else. And so that's, you know, one good thing about the smaller campus is having that access to services that you may not otherwise have. So
it's a big advantage of Grenfell that people know each other across disciplines, across kind of the different units of the university. And it is more of a community in that way, where people from different branches, if you will, are in touch with each other. So
yeah, and I do want to open it up for anyone. We have about 5 minutes, like I said. So are there any questions or thoughts or comments or anything from any of the students on the call, for anyone on the call, whether that's Kelly or Nada or myself, or are there any questions at this point about any of the services you heard about or the programs? Or yep, go ahead, Sydney.
I think this is a question for Lucas. The opt-in and opt-out, all the forms and stuff around health insurance and dental insurance, that's available through the graduate student portal at Grenfell, correct?
Yeah, I'm going to send out an email within the next couple of days on how to register, and in that I'll include a line on the opt-out process for that as well.
Okay, that's great. Thanks.
No worries.
Any other questions or comments or? Okay, so one thing I will bring up is that we're always looking for ways to connect with everyone. Like I said, I'd love to be having luncheons and coffee meetings and things in person. Unfortunately, that can't happen. But does anyone have any ideas or things that may have worked in the past? You know, over the last year, we've sort of adjusted to this virtual reality. Is there things that people have done that have worked, sort of social events or professional development events that they've been through that they'd like to share with us that we could kind of keep note of for the semester to make sure everyone stays connected?
I
If not, oh yeah, go ahead, Sydney.
I'm just throwing it out because this is something my partner and I have been involved in for several months in Alberta. He hosts an open stage jam once a month over Zoom. And Zoom recently has really, really improved the interface so that there isn't this horrible mess when you play an instrument and sing at the same time. So I don't know whether there would be enough uptake with graduate students at Grenfell, but it would be really kind of fun to host a kind of a remote kitchen party. It's a lot of fun. And it's a lovely, it's also a lovely introduction to Newfoundland music and culture, and there are some kick-ass musicians in Corner Brook. I know this for reals. So, and I'm sure there are a bunch of bad banjo players, Kellyanne, who could get in on this too. And it would be, that's just a thought. You know, maybe that could be something that could happen.
For sure.
Because music is something that has really suffered in COVID. You know, people can't get together and sing, people can't get together and make music. So might be fun, you know, sort of like a TGIF thing. Bring your own mug of tea or your own beer or whatever you know, your beverage of choice and share a song or a story or something. Just a thought.
Awesome. And I think that, I mean, like those sort of things, anything that comes up like that, one thing I will share is that we had recently did a holiday virtual escape room event last week, and that was pretty cool to get everyone together. And you have a guided person who will lead you through the escape room online, and it was pretty quite interesting. So those sort of ideas that, I mean, if anything comes up, feel free to bring those up to us or email us. And I think with that, it's 1 o'clock, so I'm going to try and keep things on time, and we will say goodbye. But before we go, it's a Monday, so everyone might be dragging their feet. But just so you know that I am having a worse day than you, I put on pants this morning that I ripped last week, and I just realized when I'm sitting here. So if you think you're having a bad Monday, at least your pants aren't ripped in the office.
Where is the rip? You have to tell me.
It's in a place that no one wants to know. So on that note, thank you again, everyone, for being here. I can't wait to meet you all. I promise I won't be wearing ripped pants when we meet. And if anything comes up, any questions?
You can't promise that.
Very true. I'll do my best. But if anything comes up between now and the next time that we see each other, keep in touch. And again, for those coming into quarantine or in quarantine, stay safe, and I hope everyone stays healthy, and we will be in touch very soon. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you, everyone.